Hey guys, it's HoppingHammy. So if you have watched one of my recent videos, you will know that Ginger Snap is being moved into my big DIY cage. And the theme that I am planning out for him is going to be in that cage, so I have tons of space to set it up. And I thought I would do a little bit of a reveal on that so that you can understand what these pet products are that I'm going to be showing you, how they'll be sort of used in that theme. So the theme is going to be, drum roll please, the theme is going to be a fairy theme, and this is something I have been wanting to do for ages, and I'm finally finding enough stuff to do it, so I'm super excited. It's going to have like little mushrooms and little stepping stones, not real mushrooms of course, but you know, pretend mushrooms, and it's going to be really cute, I hope. So I'll go ahead and show you some of the stuff that I bought. I'm not showing everything because I do want to save a bunch of stuff for surprise. So this is sort of more the like pet product stuff and not the little cutesy decor. But anyway, we'll go ahead and get started. So the first thing that I found for his theme was this little ceramic house, and I thought it looked a bit like a little fairy cottage. Now, it has the natural colors on it, and then on the back it has this cutout opening so that he can go inside and either use it as a house or use it as a little hideaway to eat his food. And then the other thing that I found was this ceramic log, and this was also from Goodwill. It has this little leaf on the side, and then it's hollow inside, and I just thought it was really cute, and I think this was like 49 cents or something, so yeah. So that was all technically that wasn't all I found at Goodwill, but that's all I'm going to show you today that I found at Goodwill. So next, I'm going to show you stuff from PetSmart. So I found this very nice shape of grape driftwood. Now there are different types of wood that are not safe for hamsters, but this is grape driftwood. Now I am going to boil this in hot water for quite a while just to get any sort of dust or dirt or germs off of it and to make it really smooth. So I like the shape of it because you can stand it up and it can look like a dead tree, or you can flip it like this and it can be like a little ramp. I just really liked the shape of it, and for the size it actually wasn't too expensive, so I thought that was really cool, and hopefully I'll be able to use that in his theme. So then the next thing that I found at PetSmart was this pack of also grape wood, and this was on clearance for $4 I believe, and it has 6 pieces of little driftwood in it, which I thought was a great deal. And these I'm also going to boil as well, but I just thought they would be cool to put like different places in his cage. And then the next thing I got was this bag of Vitacraft orchard grass, which is soft stemmed grass hay. And it's nice because it doesn't feel like it's going to be pokey. So this I'm going to be sprinkling around the cage to make it smell good and to make it sort of look like grass. So I was really excited, and it smells really good. I love the smell of hay. I said that in one of my other videos too. So then I got this little bag of willow sticks, all living things. And these are really inexpensive. I like them because you can stack them up and they sort of look like little logs. I found these at Dollar Tree actually, which these are just natural rocks, and these are the types of rocks, actually a little bit bigger ones, that I have used in my cages, and I've never had any problems with them. I've been using them for quite a few years now. They're so much cheaper than the ones that you buy in like the aquarium section. So these were just a dollar, and I'm going to be using these to make like stepping stone pathway and stuff like that, so yeah. And then the last thing I will show you, which again, I'm not showing everything, I'm just picking a few things to give a sneak peek. Now this isn't actually for his fairy cage theme, I just bought them because they were on sale. These are some more of those cardboard cutouts. Now I have 5 bags here, and I wasn't going to buy that many, but when they rang up at the cash register, they were only 10 cents, and they weren't even marked as 10 cents, so I was like, ooh, I gotta grab some more. So I grabbed all of these, and yeah, I mean, I'll use them eventually. So I guess that's all I'll be showing for now, because I don't want to spoil the surprise too much, and I'm not sure if that'll be my next video or if I'll have something else, because it's gonna take me a long time to like set the cage up and everything. But anyway, thank you for watching this mini haul, and I'll see you again soon. Bye.